and start another one. This one's probably not going to be that long. Let's identify these rings first, see if there's... Oh. Well, time to leave. Go to another place. And thanks to cartography, we have this. The way home. Teleports us right here. We got a blueprint. Radiant Star Shard. And that's it. We have two. And if we find the temple, the Starlight Temple, we can upgrade our gear to cosmic gear. Legendary gear that we can put into the vault if necessary. Before we do anything, let's check through our stuff to find out if there's anything we want saved. Oh, this does more damage, that's good. I'm gonna save that just in case. Because I like eager, because the whole multiple attack thing. But it doesn't happen every time, so that's kind of sucks. Holy crap, that's a lot of spell power. Hello! 9%, that's a nice idea there. We lose some health, but... we'll be fine. We'll be able to do stuff more. That's 5%. That's gonna... Oh, we're close to 5% reduction in stamina use abilities, and that's what we mainly use. Oh, time to melt down our gear. And time to go out and get another star shard because there's another ancient place to go to. Let's see if we can spend any... Nope. Don't have any points. First, let's go to town. Let's go to Stonebottom and make their prosperity maximum. Wait, that's Seven Spring Haven. What the hell am I doing here? There we go. And with this, we will have a high town with... high stuff. High grade inventory. Usually the upgrades are immediate, if I recall correctly. Yeah, they're about the same so far. Let's go upgrade this town. See what they have here. Most of this episode is probably going to be just buying potions. Oh, Doom Talker! What do you have? Pokey Beatdown. And there's the shoulders. Couldn't get if we wanted to. But I will keep an eye out for those, because more armor and dodge is not a bad thing. And once again, continue buying potions, because why the hell not? I wonder if they have a scroll of defy damage. No. Time to check the other stores to see if they have scroll of defy damage. Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to mention is that if you go here, you can rest and relax and refill your health and everything. Or you can ask around town if there's any information. Such as this! Resting in towns! Okay, time to go towards that other ancient ruins. First, explore around a bit. Get an idea of what's going on. Oh yeah, this is the way to start the final dungeon. Well, one of the final dungeons. I'm not gonna start it yet. Leveled Fortress Jade. This time I won't be a moron and summon as many enemies as possible. He says that he summons every fucking enemy on the earth. Yeah, this is just utterly ridiculous. Where did the fortress go? I did not know I have that much verb built up. I know I joke about demolishing a dungeon in one go, but damn! Come on. We all know what's gonna happen here. Best to just roll down and die. Actually, no, don't. I need to be entertained. Entertain me with your futile resistance. Dual-wielding fists allows us to do dual-wielding abilities, such as cutting people. Oh, this just got bad. Where are all the champions? There's one champion. There was one champion. that's not where I aimed it, but okay. Okay, I got complacent. I shouldn't have gotten complacent. I nearly died. I was too overconfident. Oh, hey, a book. Now we know where to find the Star Temple. I really shouldn't get overconfident. Time for Battle Potion Champion and Ironwood. Oh boy, what's wrong now? Ugh. And dead. Now we just need clan process and then we're good to go. Okay, so this went better than the last one. then again, we destroyed most of the fortress. Time to go for the way home. Oh my eye. My microphone keeps on slipping down. Again, let's look at our gear, see what we have. Anything that we can put into the vault, I am going to try and save. So far, looking to be a big nope. Technically, that is better, but we'd lose more poison resistance. Then again, we don't block, so... Oh, wow, no. Getting closer. Then we can upgrade the vault and keep our items safe. Still not enough. Night after night. Something waiting for us east of here. Ah, I got a general direction. So let's go and get those star shards and make cosmic gear. Actually, let's go back in here and use all three. So it's east of here. Southeast now. There we go. Ancient Starlight Temple. We now can get cosmic. Are you fucking kidding me? Oh, thank God. Because if it blocked me from getting to this place, I'd be pissed. Now let us make cosmic gear. Do we dare wield the power of ancient kings? Of course we do. Oh Oh, I didn't know we can do it to these. Cosmic Evasive Indigo Seared Verdant Trench Coats plus 7. It can now be placed in the War Vault. We have, and yeah. Oh, it's about to get more awesome. Now to use the final one to upgrade our bow. Now let us look at our gear. Plus 2 strength, 4 plus strength, 8 plus skill, so that, yeah, our cosmic gear ups our stats a lot. And gives us a lot more benefits. We are strong. We have gotten stronger. It is time to utterly decimate things. Assuming I can get out of the Starlight Temple. How did I get in here? Oh, that's how. Our stats have increased a lot. We can utterly decimate anything in our path. Well, anything within our level limits. No, trees are immune to thunder. Crawl of Forgotten Minerva. Let's start this. Yep, I won't get too cocky, Zerfall. I'm gonna keep a monitor on my health. Oh hey, look at that. It's a Nerf bat. Twenty-four health. Now it's nothing. Oh shit. Almost 2,000 hit points of damage. I think we're good. Wow. Oh, this has gotten awesome. Almost 3k health. Oh yeah, I tried some Tim Hortons to wake up. Very strong coffee. Not used to it yet. Tastes good though. This could be some trouble. Yes, dark roast. tasted very good. Matter of fact, all I have is Tim Hortons Dark Roast. The actual Tim Hortons that was located in my town closed some time ago. Didn't get enough business. Then a Panera Bread took its place. Didn't get enough business. Yeah, I can see why it can taste good, because woke me up pretty quick. Almost forgot this. Technically my cup is 2 cups of coffee. I think regular would be one cream and one sugar. I'm not sure. I don't measure my cream and sugar. I just measure it to a point where I can actually drink the coffee. Because having it straight, I just can't have coffee just straight black. Far too bitter for my taste. Does wake me up a lot. I try to make sure the ratio of coffee to cream is like, it gets to like a light brown or dark brown color. If my coffee turns completely white, then I no longer have coffee, I have a cup of milk. I try to avoid that. Oh, hey! We're not even gonna do this. Because that can be instant death. And right now I'm at a comfortable position. Where I can just walk over everything. Kinda wanna get another cup of Tim Hortons right now. But I'm not too sleepy for it. More scrolls of bees, please. Let's see. Bees, please does this. Dropping gold on that idol will get me a really powerful item, or something that can kill me in one punch, or one go around. Sometimes they're stronger than an ancient king, sometimes they're just as strong as the final boss. I don't like to gamble when it comes to certain things. If it's an early character and I have the potions, yeah, sure, I'll do it. I'll do a video demonstrating it with one of my other files. Yes, I won't put the torch on the altar. Yeah. Oh, Zerfall, you're gonna like this. First time going through second time going through one of the dungeons in Darkest Dungeon. I found this altar thing. It said, put a torch on here if you want to meet the void. And I was like, what does this do? And one person in chat, Freshmaker, he said, put the torch on it repeatedly. And I decided, I was wondering what it was doing, what it was going to do at first. Until finally, instead of waiting for an answer, I just went, eh, nothing ventured, nothing gained. And then I got, then I found out why you don't put the torch on the altar. What, some Eldritch Shambler thing completely annihilated my party. Because I was not prepared. So woefully underprepared. And I felt so much pain that day. Lost the team. Then again, it was supposed to be the B team, so... Yeah, now I have another B team. I probably should get back to Darkest Dungeon sometime. Oh yes, I did meet the Void. And the Void didn't... The Void had nothing to say except... Bohica. Oh hey, we actually summoned every enemy in the map. Found the secret door. Okay, this is just ridiculous. Half the map is now gone. Our verve got so high we just eliminated half the map in one punch. And this is where the Grim Reaper statue will bring you. Might as well try it. We have three chests here. One, they'll either give us a good item or make us regret it. I'm gonna regret this. I need to get a D4. Let's see, which chest do I choose, or do I let the chat choose? Chest number one. Huh. That was more profitable than I was expecting it to be. I was expecting an ancient king god or something. We won the gamble. Iridian Star Shard will give us a lot of good stuff. Once we go back to the Starlight Temple. Oh, I am shaking right now because I actually thought I was fucked. Oh boy. Speaking of D20s, here's one right now. Immune to fire sight. Oh. I did not know it could one-shot me. Whoa, what? What happened? Where am I? Oh yeah, that's the one thing I forgot to mention. There are hidden teleports. Let's rest up a bit. Or not. Powerful evil, you don't say. Rest up, your health. Punch everything. Whoa, what the hell? Damn it, there's gold on that teleporter. I can't get to it. Later dungeons do these dick moves that are just... Oh hey, it's a beholder. I really want to know how much verve we have. Because I will utterly demolish this dungeon once we get high enough. Oh man, we're getting close to seeing how far we can get. You don't run away from me. No one runs away. Okay, time to see how far our rolling thunder punch will go. Wow. Yeah. There was a dungeon here. It's gone now. Yep, just an arena now. How much of the dungeon did we destroy? Seems like the higher level we get, the more Punt Speedchunk becomes destroyer of worlds. I I think it's safe to say we eliminated all of the dungeon that we explored. Oh, found the limit. Untouched dungeon. It is an arena now. Oh dear God. This was we were supposed to explore all this. Guess we don't have to now. Alright, this is getting ridiculous. Dear God. How many of you assholes are here? I'm surrounded by assholes. Not me, that's for sure. Sergeant asshole, major asshole, private asshole. Lieutenant asshole. It says powerful evil. I think that's the boss dungeon, or boss of the room. Ruins. Ah, that was an astromancer. Getting ridiculous with all the attacks we're doing. Cosmic gear really is shining through. Oh, there's only one boss dungeon door left. Yeah. Oh, it's not the boss room. Oh my. I just love all this ridiculousness that's going on. When you're super strong, this game can get fun. Although starting off, it's like Morrowind. First 12 levels are gonna suck. What the hell are you? Purple-aided tiger. Okay then. We have adequate defense. I love the fact that the whole bleeding Red Rand River's special attack has no range on it. No range except infinite range. Wow, that was unexpected. Then again, we are at dangerous level, which has high chance for high rewards, but the risk is all the more greater. Level 12, oh shit. Level 12. Nothing here. Oh hey, it's the boss room. We'll find out what that boss is in a minute. We just need to explore every room on this floor. This is getting all kinds of ridiculous right now. I know I keep saying that, but it's just like never expect to get any more ridiculous than what we've been doing. Usually I think we hit a high point of the ridiculous levels and then all of a sudden, bam, potato salad. Let's see what we have here. Do we have any armor that's better than the one? No, we're not gonna have any armor better than the ones we have now. Do we have any good items? Because we've been picking up a lot of shit. Well, all of them are going to be used for fodder for melting down and upgrading our equipment. Should the horrific event or eyes of us dying. Ogbars, huh? Oh, see you later, Ogbart. 900 health, oh you poor mother. Oh, that was nice. Hey, I forgot to check on our stats. Wow, we are immune to fire, 100% resistance. Our armor rating is 227. So many skills, we can't be touched. That's why armor potions are a godsend. They also give you some immunity to the spells. What the hell was that? Oh, dread purple damage, huh? To the overworld. Now back to the temple. The Starlight Temple. And upgrade another gear to cosmic levels. Assuming I can get through it again. Let's upgrade the glove we have. And we have more armor. More health. Not so much anything else. That'll help us in the long run. Time to get out of here. Okay, then. Skill, the way home, go here. Now we have more stats to upgrade, hopefully. I'll give this some thought. We could upgrade, do this. Or we can just upgrade this so we can have all equal stats, but yeah, I'll give it some thought later. Meantime, let's look at those rings we have. Let's see, we have. Yeah, I think I'm going to go with this one. So our stamina regenerates 179% faster. Continue looking through all these, see if there's anything we want to save. Nope. Now we can upgrade our starting item. Should the need arise. We're getting more. Almost have every unlocked enchantment. Ah, oh, there's the eager thing. I didn't know that. I thought that was one of those ones you couldn't make. Which means I can definitely add this to the bow we have. However, that's all the time I have now. Been streaming for 3+ hours. So thank you all for coming to the stream. See you all later.